Mark David Chapman, the man who shot John Lennon outside his Manhattan apartment in 1980, is set to make another application for parole. Liverpool Post editor Mark Thomas was holidaying in New York as Chapman appeared in court. And not wanting to miss a scoop, he took his notepad downtown for the biggest story on the planet.
Well, it was by one of those strange quirks of fate, really. I happened to be going on holiday to New York at the time to visit my cousin. And when I read a couple of days before I was due to go that Mark Chapman was going to be making his first appearance in the Central Criminal Court in New York while I was going to be in the city, the actual wait for getting into the court was probably the most startling part of it, because we queued for probably an hour and a half before getting into court while they sorted out various details and accreditations and everything else for all the journalists and all the other sort of observers who wanted to be there for what was, I suppose, in its awful way, a moment of history. Once we got into the court itself, it was pretty much a little different, obviously, than an English court, but very familiar to anyone who's covered courts the world over, I'm sure. There was a judge in plain clothes, as I recall, and there were lawyers. We were all sat down, and probably after we'd been in for about 5 minutes, Chapman was brought in, surrounded by security and by his own legal advisers. I saw him but didn't see a lot of him. Most of the time he sat with his back to me. And there was just a sense of unreality, really, that we were sitting in a court with someone who could have committed a crime which had such enormous impact on a whole generation of people, myself included. I think it's about his seventh or eighth attempt at parole. My own view is that it's probably not appropriate for him to get parole at the moment. Yoko and Sean have said, and certainly Yoko will be opposing his parole application once again this time, that they would never feel safe again if he was free. And I think their feelings in this, they're the ultimate victims of what happened when all's said and done. We all felt as though we'd had an enormous loss when John died, but clearly they suffered more than any of us. And I think those views and those opinions should be sacrosanct. Obviously, there is a question of rehabilitation and how much time someone spends inside and how long is appropriate. But in the case of such an enormous crime, and one that was clearly only done to achieve some kind of spurious notoriety, I mean, the callous disrespect for any life, let alone the life of such a fantastic artist as John Lennon, I don't think there's an excuse for it, and I personally would be very saddened and dismayed, I think, if he was given parole.